Hey guys, my name is Pedrotsky, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can set up a Quake Live server inside of Pterodactyl. Now it's actually pretty straightforward using Pterodactyl. If you don't know what Pterodactyl is, basically it's a game server manager software that you can install. It's free, it's super simple to get up and running. I've actually got a guide, so if you just want to check the link in the description, you can be up and running in about 5 or 10 minutes with your server, and it's going to make managing multiple game servers just so much easier. You'll be able to give your friends access. Like, trust me, if you have to be running your server with Pterodactyl these days. So the only issue is we can't install Quake Live by default with Pterodactyl, so that's what this guide's for. So after you install Pterodactyl, basically you'll come to a screen like this, and we're just going to click settings in the top right. Then we're going to go down to nests. So there's two different things. There's a nest, which is basically like a folder, and then there's configuration files. So configuration files are like the different games that you run. So for example, if we go into source engine here, you'll see that there's like a bunch of different games, and these are the current games that we can install on our server. So we're going to create a new nest. So I'm going to click create new and just going to call it custom games. So click save. And then if we click on nest again, now we're going to have to grab the egg. So I'll also have the configuration file located in the description, and it's from this dude here called Parker. He's got a nice repo and a bunch of eggs, like with different game servers. So I've already downloaded that. So you can download it actually by clicking code and then just click download zip. And then all we need to do is just go click import egg. I'm gonna choose the file. So I'm going to eggs master. Then we go to game eggs, we go Steam CMD servers, we go to Quake Live, and then you'll see here it's egg-quake-live. So double click that and click set the nest to just custom games. Really, it can go in any of these, but it's just set up a separate folder for your custom ones, for your custom eggs. So then we click import. So that's imported. Now we go over and we're going to need to set the actual server up. So we click on servers, click on create new. So I'm going to call it Quake Live, put in the server owner, Pedro. And then we can pretty much just leave everything else here as default. We need to put in the amount of memory and disk space we want it to use. I just like setting it as zero, just as unlimited. It's a pretty lightweight game anyway. Nest, we need to select custom games, and then egg Quake Live. And then here's like where we can change like the FPS. Like for example, I'll set this to like 125. You can change the server name, server type, etc. Like number 2 is internet, 1 for LAN, 0 for offline. The password, if you want a password, protect it. And then just click on create server. So that's installing now. If we go click Pterodactyl at the top left and then we click on Quake Live, we'll be able to see that it's actually installing now. So that's pretty much it. That's that's really it. The only thing you have to do is after the game is installed is you just need to connect to the server. So you can either look for it in the server browser, or you can just click on the IP address over here and then you'll just connect directly to that IP address. So that's it guys, you just wait for this to install and your server should be up and running. Now, if you get stuck at any time, I've got a link to my Discord in the bottom. Just come and join us. We've got a tech support channel where people will help you out. Or just even leave a comment below. I'll do my best to help you out. So thanks for watching guys. If it helped you as well, also give me a like and a subscribe, that would really help. So thanks for watching guys, and I hope to see you in the next video.